tips for running an effective public relation campaign. First, you need to set an objective, restrictions, and metric of victory. Think yourself, what do you trust to attend together with your campaign, or do you need to reach a new audience? Once you have chosen a big picture objective, limit it down, at least, by laying a campaign guide, you are giving yourself a centered metric to measure your success. And second, know your audience. Sometime recently, you will be able to select how you need to provide your public relation messages. You must choose who you need to get it. Take the time to set up which client persona you want this campaign to reach. Number 3, choose the right stage. Once you have chosen one on a target, you will need to select your favorite stage for delivering your message. For occurring, that's the perfect group of onlookers' favor, TV or radio, a press release or a press conference. This data will assist you strategize everything else.
Vaksinasi COVID-19 peringkat Kementerian Pertahanan dan Angkatan Tentera Malaysia telah bermula minggu ini setelah penerimaan vaksin pada Isnin 23 Februari 2021. Program ini adalah lanjutan daripada fasa pertama program imunisasi COVID-19 nasional bagi melindungi barisan hadapan yang terdiri daripada warga ATM. Bertempat di Hospital Angkatan Tentera Tuanku Mizan hari ini 26 Februari, program vaksinasi telah dirasmikan Menteri Pertahanan Datuk Seri Ismail Sabri bin Yaakob dan menyaksikan Barisan Pengurusan Tertinggi Kementerian dan ATM menerima suntikan dos pertama mereka. Panglima Tentera Laut Laksamana Tan Sri Muhammad Reza bin Muhammad Sani bersama timbalannya Laksamana Madya Datuk Abdul Rahman bin Ayub dan warga Navy People yang terpilih turut sama menerima suntikan vaksin mereka pada hari ini. Timbalan Menteri Pertahanan, Panglima Angkatan Tentera, Ketua Setiausaha Kementerian, Panglima Tentera Darat dan Panglima Tentera Udara antara 162 penerima vaksin pada hari ini.
Saya rasa ini memang satu sinar harapan buat kita semua, terutamanya pada Navy People, untuk tampil ke depan sama-sama kita menyambut seruan kerajaan, lindungi diri, lindungi semua.
So, tak perlu nak takut, kita jaga diri kita, jaga keluarga dan jaga masyarakat sempat, insyaAllah.
Five Power Defence Regiment FPDE Establishment. The Five Power Defence Regiment was established in 1971 through a series of bilateral exchanges of notes between Malaysia, Singapore, Australia, New Zealand and the United Kingdom. The purpose is to provide external defence support for Malaysia and Singapore. Next, we go to the multilateral arrangement. The FPDA is the only multilateral arrangement that has the element of conventional warfighting. Since 2004, the FPDA has incorporated non-conventional domains such as counter-terrorism, maritime security and humanitarian assistance and disaster relief. regular exercise. Conducts regular exercise, namely bernama Shield, bersama 5, Suman Protector and Suman Warrior. All FPDA exercises are conducted based on a joint approach comprising of the Navy, Air Force and Army elements. Operational Arm, known as Headquarters Integrated Air Defense System, headed by a commander, Headquarters Integrated Air Defense System is situated at RMAF Batu Wood at A Base Penang.